I've been collecting records since I was like 15, so I opened a record store after I got out of high school. Yeah, me and my dad started it in 2006. Yeah, that's 10 years ago, good lord. It was just more or less something to do. I didn't go to college, so I was just like, oh, well, I gotta try and do something with my life. So yeah, we started the store, and been working pretty good. We moved from, our first location was in Hearst, and then we moved from Hearst to Montgomery Street, over there, over kind of the Arts District area. And me and my dad moved this entire place by ourselves. Damn near killed us. But yeah, we moved from Montgomery Street over to here, I guess 4 years ago. I hope not to ever move again, but things happen, so we'll see how that goes. A lot of our customers shop here specifically because everything's graded and sleeved. So they know what they're getting. They don't have to look at everything. And our customer service is great for the most part. Sometimes we get a little grumpy, but we go through, clean pretty much anything that needs to be cleaned. We put a sleeve on it and we grade it, price it, the whole nine yards. So, I mean, people know what they're getting when they come here. It's like they buy something, they can pretty much guarantee that it's going to be the quality that they expect. I'm usually out a couple days a week, sometimes more depending on my schedule fits, but looking at records, you know, sometimes I go out and buy 10, 15,000 records at a time. Whenever I'm here during the day, most of the people that bring stuff in, they're gonna have like, you know, a box of records or a couple boxes of records, but I do make house calls for bigger collections, you know. It's like, I think the biggest one we ever bought, we bought like 40,000 records one time, and that was a lot of work. I don't know, it's like, I have an iPod and all that stuff, so like, people always collect stuff. People have been doing it for forever, you know, it's just like, they always want to have things, and like, it's like, what's great about records is, well, not to mention, it's something that holds its value a lot better, like, you buy an MP3, you're not getting that money back. It's like, you buy a record, sometimes the value of that record goes up, I mean, well, most of the time it doesn't, but you can still get something back out of that record. If you buy a record, it'll come with a download code most of the time, like, as far as new stuff goes. You can download it, have on your iPod, phone, your car, and stuff like that, but, you know, if you're at home, you know, it comes with posters, liner notes, but just all the just awesome stuff. So if you want to hang out and chill in your house, read the liner notes, all that kind of thing, it's really good for that. But you know, it's like if you turn around and you get the pickle and you need some money, you can also sell it. So it's good. It's good on both fronts.
Something really cool about like actually owning the music that you're listening to. Like with digital music, it just feels like it's floating out in cyberspace somewhere. Whereas with like vinyl, you can actually hold it in your hands, and it also sounds a little bit better to me, at least.
I like the idea of Record Store Day because like it gets a lot of people in the store, and I usually have a blast. I don't particularly like the part of Record Store Day, like the Record Store Day releases. I mean, at first it wasn't that bad, but now it's more like, it just seems like they're trying to force a little too much. People, like, the record companies, like, they overprice stuff. The packaging is weak in a lot of cases. And then, like, they're just trying to find anything to put out because they know people are going to buy it, even if it's garbage. Like, I mean, I'm just pretty much over that aspect of it. I mean, I love having my customers come out and have a good time. Like, we get some food and drinks and some bands and have a sale, and it's a great time. But like the whole you know, Record Store Day release thing is just it's been exhausted at this point. In its days, in down to like help out local bands. If like they want to come play, it's like I am kind of picky on who I choose based on my customer base. You know, it's like there's some people that, you know, it's like their band's not gonna fit as well in here as others. I have people approach me, and then the guys that work here, they're all in bands and they know bands, and they get them, ask them to come play and that kind of thing. So yeah, it's always really awesome.
I play drums for Jake Palachek. I met him in Nashville with like a, we were living like this 10 songwriter house at the time. And then he moved here, and I ended up moving here with another band, and we've been playing for I guess now 3 years.
I'd actually never been to Doc's Record before, but one of my friends told me about it. He was saying there's a bunch of cute records and some vintage girls, and those are two of my favorite things. That mixed with live music, how can I complain?
I come to Doc's Records probably like once a month, because it has definitely like the best selection of any record store in Fort Worth. And also the fact they have some live music every now and then, it's pretty tight. Like we saw Fog today, and I like have idolized them for a while, and they're from here.
Me and my dad are just goofy as hell, so we just put weird stuff everywhere. We want to add a lot of the stuff we like to put in here, because it's like people like to bring their significant others or kids or whatever to the record store, and you know, a lot of them do not like records. So it gives us something else to look at. You know, we got books, we got clothes, little knickknacks, toys, all kinds of stuff like that. So it's like, it's a little something. We try to make it a little something for everybody, essentially. So I think it's fake, and I don't know where it's at, but I bought a box of stuff one time, and when I was going through it, I found like a severed finger and a molding. I could only assume that it was fake, but it looked pretty real, and I was all like, whoa, that's bananas. So yeah, that was pretty weird. I need to start writing all this stuff down. I get weird stuff all the time. But as far as like records go, you still get cool stuff like ventriloquists, which is, I don't understand that. It's just a picture of them on the front holding their dummy and then them talking on the record. They make all kinds of weird records, man. It's like the, what was it? The seances. Like, they did a seance with Harry Houdini. That was pretty weird. It's like people screaming. It's hilarious. But, man, it was like, there really is some bizarre stuff. A lot of it has to do with, like, Christian community. Like, stuff back in the 50s, you know, scare tactics, that kind of thing. Oh, man, I have a lot of it. There's, like, people, like, you're going to hell for this, that, and that. And then, like, they'll have, like, there was one where it was so-called like somebody on LSD, and they're freaking out and screaming and stuff like that. But yeah, there's a lot of weird stuff.
One of the reasons I really like Doc's is because the employees are really nice, and I've talked to a couple of them, and they're all in like really cool bands. I know one of them is in Cleanup, one of them is in the Fungi Girls, so they know their stuff basically. And they have a good variety of records, like new and used, for good prices. And it's right by like All Saints and Country Day, so I just come by here.
I enjoy being amongst people that are like-minded. I enjoy the atmosphere. It's a fun setting. It's a good setting.
It's the first record store I ever went to. Before I was in Nashville and such, and so there was a bunch of like cool record stores over there, and this is my first introduction to Fort Worth kind of record stores, and they just have a bunch of stuff. It's crazy.
It seems like there's not one place to get all your music, I guess, except physically That's even sort of like.
Well, I mean, like, yeah, you can always buy. Well, I mean, not always. I guess some people just purely do downloads now. I think that's mainly like upstart bands and things of that nature. But you know, it's like for the most part, you can buy a physical copy of anything that comes out. Gets people to come in the store. You know, it's like hanging out in a record store is always fun. Anyway, you get to browse through stuff and like. You see something, you don't know what it is, and you're like, oh, cool, I'm going to check this out, and then you got your favorite record or whatever else. And the other people in the store are cool, too, besides the employees and stuff like that. They'll try and hit you with some new stuff based on your the type of music you listen to. So your record stores are good for that, too. It's kind of, I don't know. You know, this is all you can do is keep doing what you're doing. As long as I'm still surviving and trying to have a good time and have some customers, I'll keep doing. But you know, if the bottom falls out, so be it. You know, I guess I can go sell cars or I don't know, whatever big dudes with curly hair do whenever their business falls apart. So, but yeah, I think it looks good for now. You know, it's again, like it's a community aspect of it that people I think really enjoy. They come to the record store, you know, BSing with me or the guys behind the counter. Hopefully we're in a good mood. Sometimes terrible things happen here and it throws us off. But yeah, I mean, most of the time people come in, we're super happy to help out and they talk to the other customers and you know, it's fun. It's not like sitting at home and just picking stuff out. It's a totally different experience.
Trying to care.